You know, I feel very proud that we get to do this work. We're going to be testing a wide range of masks. So some of them have come from medical professionals who have a surplus and the state wants to verify they're doing well. We're also in the process of gearing up to do large-scale testing of big manufacturers to verify performance. Right now, we're focusing whenever possible on N95 methodology and testing of N95 masks. So they're the first priority for the state. But the process in general starts with us taking a mask and sealing it down to a little bit of a test fixture. It then goes into our aerosol chamber behind us, where we flow air through the mask, and we measure the amount of particles outside the mask and the number of particles in the mask. We can use that to get a really good estimation of how efficient the mask is. At the same time, we're also measuring pressure drop across the mask. It's not just about how well it filters, but a mask that has too high of a pressure drop actually puts too much burden on a person who's breathing and can be downright dangerous, to be honest. We're very fortunate that Colorado State University has a really robust aerosols program. In the past, it hasn't been geared towards mask testing necessarily, but we have both the expertise and the equipment to do this type of testing, and we had the ability to ramp up the testing very, very quickly. Right now, I have an opportunity to work in an empty lab, so keeping myself distanced from people, and do testing that's really going to have large impact, both locally in Fort Collins, as well as potentially the state and the nation, to get this really needed resources out to the community.